Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to my NCAA 14 Ultimate Team series. This is episode 6, and we are for the first time going to play an online Ultimate Team game. Had to wait quite a while for someone to actually have the disc, and guess who came through? My buddy Jamila the Killer. You never heard of him? Really? Oh, he's a big Ultimate Team guy over on Madden. And he's always fed my teams nicely over there with talent, and we love to play games against each other. Now, what you need to know about games between myself and Jamila. We're not exactly cutthroat playing the game. We like to have fun. We like to hurdle just like that. My goodness, look at him go flying in the air. It is Philip Rivers. So Jamila's got his team knocking on the door. He's going to go with the slant there and get the catch. Ogletree gets himself a touchdown, and it's 7-0. We go to a screen to Jerome Harrison here, and another hurdle and a big hit. Yeah, we're always trying to time those hurdles for mid-air collisions just right. Oh, look at the little gamesmanship here, dragging his foot over Jerome Harrison. I see how you are. Alex Smith back to pass, and it's picked off. And speaking of interceptions, they are very smooth in this game. No longer do you have that two-second turn the camera and have everybody like frozen in midair. No, it's all like instant and really silky smooth this year. Lance Moore, oh, he's open. Look at this. Nice cut, and he finds daylight all the way to the end zone. Yes, touchdown, and of course finishes it off with a stylish hurdle as he goes into the end zone. So, yeah, back to our games, you know, Jamila and I. The goal isn't to come out and humiliate each other and, you know, come out and dominate and win 40-0 and all this stuff. We come out to entertain. This is usually during live streams when we're just kind of trying to play and have fun. So you'll see some strange goings on once in a while. Not just the hurdling, but, you know, we'll do some things in situations that don't really make a whole lot of sense. Like, oh, I don't know. Not kicking field goals from the 5-yard line, and speaking of field goals from the 5-yard line, oops, I don't think he did that on purpose, but he did miss the kick. So it's 7-7 with just a couple minutes left. The game freezes, giving Alex Smith some time to read the defense, and he goes to Lance Moore for the first down. So I am trying to actually get downfield here, and I hit Santana Moss. No one's going to catch him, except he wants everyone to catch him. They want to kill this clock out before attempting the game-winning field goal. So we're under a minute now, third and goal. He's got one timeout left. Well, he's got no timeouts left after that kneel down. So let's kick this and get the lead. Stuttering. Here it goes. Oh, it finally goes through. Thank you, game, for not freezing and kicking us out at the crucial moment. So just seconds left here, 15 seconds to be exact. And that throw over the middle, that's a great diving catch. What a great play. Clock will wind here on the first down, and he's got one last play. Oh, he completes it. Dante Whitner saves the game with the tackle one-on-one right there, or he could have had the game-winning touchdown. Woo! Fun game. That one, we played pretty close to the vest in that one. There wasn't a whole lot of hijinks, and I end up winning the game 10-7, but that's kind of the secondary effect. We wanted to get out here and play this game in the head-to-head season mode and see what it was all about. Now, the problem is you can't just pick a friend. Now, we were lucky because we were one of the only two people having the disc at this time, trying to connect. So it was rather easy to line up games. Then we go into a second game here between the two of us. As, oh, wow, that's a really nice pick by Jamila's defense right there. So the only real issue I have with these head-to-head season games is I would like to be able to line up a friend to play, not just a random person, now that everybody has the game. And look at Jamila. He is taking it to the house with a long pass to Ryan Broyles. 65-yard touchdown, and he's got the lead. Once again, he's the first to score as we play head-to-head here. So first quarter almost out, and Alex Smith looking for the long ball, and he's going to connect with Dwayne Harris, who will take it out of the... Oops. No, he won't take it all the way. He ran into his man. I was trying to get a blocking convoy going in there. I should have just run straight in the end zone. Silly me. But I do come back with a touchdown pass to Cumberland, my tight end, and tie the game at 7. So it's almost halftime here. And he's looking to run with Colin Kaepernick. That's a great idea because he's quick and he's got moves. But he forgot to keep the ball with him. He fumbles it. And my defense recovers. I'm wearing Florida International uniforms there, by the way, if you were curious. And there is Dwayne Harris. This time, he is sure to make sure to get in the end zone. It's 14-7, and we're in the fourth quarter. Here he comes back, though, with Kaepernick. And he finds his man diving into the end zone. He scores to tie the game, 14-all. I'm driving here to try to win the game. A minute 30 left. Jerome Harrison is going to take this up to the middle of the spin. And look at that. I was again trying to kill the clock, but I got pushed into the end zone a little sooner than I'd like to. So it's 21-14, but it does give him time to come back. So here he's rolling with Kaepernick. And, oh, he's got a nice connection right there. I believe that Devin Hester? Yeah, I think that's Devin Hester making the catch. Big play there. Second and seven now. Over the middle, it is caught, and another big first down. It'll be first and goal. We're under 30 seconds, though, as Ryan Broyles gets that in. Oh, it's the Statue of Liberty play. They made it famous in the bowl game against Oklahoma. He pulls it out of his playbook here. CJ Spiller can't quite get in, so it comes down to fourth and goal. Look at that hurdle, and wow, crazy play there with Kaepernick scoring to tie the game. Just 3 seconds left, and you were about to see the most epic play ever in the game of college football. Look at this. I've got all my linemen at my disposal here. I'm going to step up in a pocket here. I want to be really safe before I throw this bomb. Look at this. Even tighter, guys. No one's going to get to Alex Smith on this play. And, yeah, he throws it in the turf. Oh, God, we laughed so hard at that one. Okay, it wasn't the most epic play ever, but I like to think it was. So we go to the first overtime session. I say first because there's potential for more. That's a nice pass over the middle. It'll be first and goal at the 5. It is Broyles again. And here we go. Second and goal. The handoff to CJ Spiller, who, what else? Hurdles into the end zone. Of course he does. It's Jamila versus Nadas. Of course there's going to be crazy hurdling action. There, he goes for 2 and does not get it. So it's 27-21. I could win with a touchdown and an extra point, and I got a first down right there. Allen makes the catch, inbounds, and I'm good to go. So on first and goal, I'm going to hand off to Jerome Harrison, who is going to, oh, he almost scored, got stood up at the goal line, and so it'll be second and goal. And, you know, Kaepernick did it, so why not Alex Smith, right? Did I just compare Kaepernick to Alex Smith? Sorry, Colin. Okay, so Alex Smith, hey, that's kind of funny. Alex Smith lost his job to Colin Kaepernick. Huh, okay, just saying. Oh, and I go for 2 because I thought it'd be fun to try to beat him by 2, and I don't get it. So we go to his second overtime. That's some of the crazy hijinks we do here. So he gets the pick. Oh, my goodness. Well, this is all but over. And if I don't stop him from getting the 2-point return there, it would be all over. But instead, it's 27-27, so he does have to go on offense. And here comes Colin Kaepernick. Going to go nowhere. He fumbles again. And luckily, he has a lineman there to fall on it. So here we go, 4th and 8. He is going to go Wildcat formation? Really? CJ Spiller is just sunk on that play. Yeah, he was just trying to do something, you know, out of the box right there. So he gets the ball first time, this time in the 3rd overtime, goes to the end zone, but Cook is there to pick it off. Look at this now. He's looking to pitch back to a teammate. Oh my goodness, Asamoah picks up the fumble. They rule safety. Oh my God, he gets 2 points on my interception. Okay, you ever seen that before? Craziness going on. 29-27. So I got to get the field goal here and win it, or the touchdown, obviously. Lance Moore makes a catch and gives me first down. The question on everyone's mind right now is, can I find a way to score just 2 points and send this into another overtime round? No, I don't think so, and I almost won it there with a touchdown pass to Allen, but he drops it. Harrison is going to run straight forward, and it'll be 4th and 2, so it's time to kick the game-winning field goal. Reluctantly, I'm going to go ahead and end this game if I can make it, and the kick is good. So another zany, wacky, crazy Jamila versus Nadas game is in the book. He frankly is my favorite player to play online currently because, you know, we kind of have like-minded goals in mind just to kind of have fun and enjoy the game and not take it so serious. Why so serious, right? All right, so there's another episode of Ultimate Team in the books. We'll see you next time, guys.